So pain in the chest can occur pretty much anywhere from your navel, which is really in the abdomen, up to your chin. And it can have many causes, including indigestion, lung problems, and the heart. And obviously we worry if it's the heart. And classically, heart pain or angina is a central chest pain, which can sometimes go into your arm or into your neck or teeth. So chest pain is a symptom in itself, but if it's associated with nausea or breathlessness or a feeling of you becoming very unwell or sweating, then that causes more concern. It's not just the severity of the pain that might be causing those, it may actually be indicating it's the heart that's the problem. So having chest pain, of course, is not a normal thing. If in fact that chest pain comes on at rest, it is severe and it's associated with those symptoms of breathlessness, feeling sweaty and sick, maybe even vomiting, or if it goes towards your arm or your teeth or your jaw, then the fact that it's occurring at rest and it sounds like heart pain makes you worry it might be a heart attack, and that's when you should seek more urgent attention. The body is obviously very complex, and there are many organs in your chest, any of which could cause pain. Therefore, it could be from the heart, whether a heart attack or inflammation around the heart. It could be from the lungs with an infection or even a collapsed lung. It could be from your stomach with indigestion. Or of course, it could even be from your ribs and cartilages causing a more musculoskeletal pain. So if chest pain is not coming from the heart, it could be coming from your muscles. You may have sprained one of your rib muscles because you're using it to breathe all the time. You may have had an injury and it's bruised your ribs, causing a musculoskeletal pain. More commonly, it could be acid reflux that can cause a burning feeling in the center of your chest, and not just in the stomach. And of course, it may be the lungs. So classically, pleurisy is a very sharp pain that can come with both viral and bacterial infections related to a pneumonia. Occasionally, we've been fooled with a case of shingles, because shingles can cause a neurological pain that can come across the chest and feel like a band. So there are many different causes, only some of which would be the heart. It's always a tricky question to know when you should take your chest pain seriously and when you can safely ignore it. So my rules usually are that if you feel it's very severe, 10 out of 10, then there's probably a reason to get that assessed quickly. If you are very sweaty, if you're nauseated, you're vomiting with it, you feel very unwell with it, again, it's worth taking that seriously, even if it turns out to be a bad case of indigestion later. Of course, the worry with a very severe pain is that you've got either a tear in a blood vessel, which can cause an excruciating pain in the chest that goes to the back, or you're having a heart attack, which bizarrely sometimes doesn't cause that severe pain, but just makes you feel a bit breathless or uncomfortable. So if you're worried about a pain pretty much anywhere between your navel and your chin, it's unexpected, it's lasting more than 20 minutes, half an hour, it's making you feel unwell, I would take it seriously and get some attention. Of course, in the UK in particular, we're blessed that we have a very good ambulance service. So ringing 999 and declaring you've got chest pain, certainly where I work in London, will get an ambulance to you probably within about 8 minutes. And then they can make an assessment about whether they need to take you to hospital or not. Now, when you're at home waiting for that ambulance, it's good to have someone with you. In case something more serious occurs, they're available. Even if they don't know how to do any CPR, breathing exercise, it doesn't matter. There's someone there who can at least lie you on your side if you collapse. If you are there and you're known to have heart trouble before, then if you've stopped taking your aspirin, by all means take an aspirin, unless your doctor told you not to for some reason. If you've never had heart trouble and this is a central chest tightness, And if you do have an aspirin, the usual 300 milligram headache dose, then there's no harm in really taking one of those just in case it is a heart attack, because that is a very important treatment. It's simple, but it is effective even before the ambulance crew get there. It's unlikely it will do you much harm. Of course, if you're vomiting blood at that time, you're not having a heart attack, that's your stomach, and then aspirin's not a good idea. So have someone with you, call for help, and if you are a heart patient and it feels like it might be the heart and it's not your stomach, then take an aspirin.